the powerless of these disciples dealing with the Spirit. Beginning at verse 14, and when he came to his disciples, he saw the great multitude, help me read about them, and the scribes questioning with them, and straightway all the people, when they beheld him, were greatly amazed, and running to him, and saluted him, and he asked the scribes what question he had with them, and one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which hath a dumb spirit. Say, tell your neighbor, it's a dumb spirit. That dumb spirit need a favor. In verse 18, and whatsoever he taketh him, he what? Carried him, and he foamed and gnashing with his teeth. The dumb spirit don't want to get loose. The dumb spirit wants to hold on to you and attach itself to you. It's a dumb spirit. Anything that is not of God is considered a dumb spirit. He said, this question, I brought him to your disciples, but they could not heal the dumb spirit. This dumb spirit needs a favor. Say, I need a favor. Verse 17, and one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I brought unto thee my son, which hath a what? And verse 18. They could not. In verse 19, he answered him and said, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him unto me. And they brought unto him, and when he saw him straightway, the spirit teared him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed and foamed. That's a dumb spirit. And verse 21, and he asked his what? Keep reading. Church, Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believe. Take your seats. The favor of God needs to cause you to believe. If you have faith of the size of a mustard seed, you'll be able to say to any mountain in your life, be thy removed, and be thy cast into the sea. But when we mess up, we doubt in our heart. And so God is saying, for the favor of God, I'm looking for a consistent faith.
Yeah.
God is a magnet to your faith. The times that we want to cry, and the times that we want to feel sad, and we feel like we want to have an emotional breakdown, God is saying, oh, where is your faith?
Yeah.
Because there's a spirit that is attached to you, and you seem like you can't detach yourself from it. You need the favor, a miracle of God, to get healed from something that is bothering you for a long time. Don't be caught up in the church and still not free. The Bible said, whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Is there anybody free in their mind right now? Or is your mind still perplexed? Or is your mind still thinking about how your ex did you wrong? And so God is saying that, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. I want to do something new for you. He said, shall ye not know it? I will make a way in the wilderness and a river in the desert. I cannot give you this favor because you're still stuck on dumb things. You're still stuck on dead things. The favor of God for those who are following along with me is regarded or treated with preference. It's an advantage. It's a privilege to have the favor of God. We dealt with to get in the favor of God. I got to get in the face of God to get the favor of God and his presence. presence, the Bible declares, is the fullness of joy. It's the Father wants to give you the favor. It's the Father that wants to bless you. It's the Father that wants to strengthen you. But I got to get in His presence. But there are some things that is hindering us from getting in the presence of the Lord. When I want to do good, evil is ever present with me. I'm trying to live right, but evil seems to attach itself to me. I'm trying to get to the hand of God, but evil is stopping me. I'm trying to go to the next dimension of God, but self is stopping me. And so God is saying, you got to come up higher. You got to come up higher in your faith to get the things what God has for you. Don't allow the enemy to bamboozle you and think that favor doesn't exist. A sinner can survive from grace and mercy, but a sinner can't get the favor of God. He said, there is no good thing I'll withhold from you, Reynard, if you walk up rightly before me. When you walk up rightly before God, you will get God's hand. Dealing with this favor, because I want to tap from just the natural to the supernatural. Someone say supernatural. Supernatural. Let's deal with Psalms. Let's go to Psalms chapter 30. The vision of Psalms. And Psalms don't have chapters, so please forgive me. The vision of Psalms. Psalms 30. 1 through 7. This is David here, a thanksgiving for deliverance from death. Deliverance from almost lost your mind. Don't you know favor would slip in and give you the mind of Christ when you was that close about to lose it? When we get delivered, we need to give God the best praise. That's why I don't stop people from praising God, because you don't know what they've been through. You don't know how they almost lost it. But it was God that redeemed them. It was God that saved them. That's why God said, I called you. I called you out of darkness, Mother Roger. I brought you to the marvelous light. So since you've been delivered from darkness, can you give God some praise? You are an ex-soldier. Maybe you're an ex-drug dealer. Maybe you're an ex-convict. Maybe you're an ex-whore.
Talk
back to me, church. He said, "Though to rejoice over me, there's people want to see you fall. But God, they want to see you fall so you won't get the favor of God. They want to see you fall so you can't start your own business. They want to see you fall so you won't finish school. They want to see you fall so you won't have a good marriage. Those are foes. They want to rejoice. People want to rejoice over your downfall. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. They want to rejoice. They don't want you to make it. They don't want you to succeed. But the Bible said, greater, greater, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. There's greatness inside of you. That problem may be great, but it's greater than dwells inside of me." God is saying that I want to give you something. He says, 2 says, "Oh Lord, my God, I will what? Cry unto thee that thou hast healed me." Y'all got to understand, I heal. I'm the God that healeth thee. I'm the God that take away thy disease. He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with the beating of Jesus, by his stripes I'm healed. 39 stripes, same one, and then one is me, boo. He said he died, got beaten for you. Anybody give grace and mercy. I want the favor of God. Uncommon favor. Thou has, oh my God, I'm talking about things have not even entered into the heart of man. Things that men can't even think about. That's the favor I want. Somebody need to pour on the anointing of God, because I feel in my spirit. I don't play with the anointing. I feel like if somebody just released a praise, some favor is going to fall on me. I cried from the depths of my soul. That's why David was a man after God's own heart. He was from the depths of his soul. I want to be delivered so God can favor me. Even the Bible minister shall tell us that David was an apple of God's eye. That's how much God loved David, because David understood repentance. David understood being delivered. He said, "Create God. About deliverance, it was David. David was adulterous. David was a killer. David was a whoremonger. David was a liar. David was a cheater. He said, "Deliver me." Oh my God. If anybody need to be delivered, oh come on, slip up your hands. I need to be delivered from something. Maybe it's yourself you need to be delivered from. So God can give you some favor. The soul from the grave. You was almost graveyard dead. Thou hast kept me alive. It was God that kept me from the bullets. It was God that kept me from that bad relationship. That bad relationship. God said, "No, don't go with them." And you find out that person got HIV now. Because God saved you. You said, "Brought me up from the soul from the grave. Thou has kept me alive." I kept you alive so I can give you some favor. I want to give you. There's riches in heaven that God wants to bestow upon you. I kept you alive so you can do what I have called you to do. He said that I should not go down to the pit. So the pit is calling somebody. You hear the voice of the pit. I shed out of myself. The pit is darkness. The pit is isolation. The pit is despair. The pit is frustration. That voice is calling you. That pit don't want you to get favor. So when you're in darkness, God can't do nothing for you because you're in the pit. Somebody need to come out the pit. Somebody need to come out the pit. He says, 4 says, sing unto the Lord, O ye saints, and keep reading, of his what? And give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. Sabashay. Stop playing with God. He's holy. Oh, he's holy. His holiness. His purity. His sovereignty. He's majestic. He's a sovereign God. He's a holy God. And so God is saying that don't you know who I am? I believe, Minister D, if we can understand.